composition functions, we have functions within functions today. The notation for a composition function, it could say, well, we would read this as g of f of x. Notice this is an open circle. When it's multiplying, it'll just be a little black dot. But if it's a composition, it'll have an open circle. You can also write it this way, g of f of x. So kind of like the order of operations, you're going to work from the inside out. So it says here you would evaluate the inner function f of x first, and then use your answer from that as the input for the outer function g of x. I will show you an example here and it might make more sense. Number three, we're going to find g of f of negative 5. If I rewrite that, I could write it this way too. So working inside out, I first have to evaluate the f function when x equals negative 5. That's what this inside part is telling me. So if I evaluate the f function when x is negative 5, I'm going to substitute negative 5 up here into the f function. Instead of it saying x minus 2, it's going to say negative 5 minus 2, so we get negative 7. Good so far?
Okay.
F of negative 5 is the same as negative 7. So now we can say g of negative 7. I'm just replacing this f of negative 5 with negative 7. Now this tells me take negative 7 and put it in the g function, which is x squared. So we're going to do negative 7 squared, which would give us 49. And that would be your final answer. So we have a function inside of a function here. There's another one over here. F of g of negative 3. If you want, you can rewrite that to look like this. So you have to do the inside function first. So we're supposed to substitute negative 3 for x in the g function, which is x squared. So then we're going to take negative 3 and square it, which gives us 9. So now we replace 9 where we see g of negative 3. So we're going to evaluate f of 9. So we're going to substitute 9 in for the f function. So we're going to take 9 minus 2. We get 7. If you substitute a numerical value in, you should get a numerical value out. You try the next one. On this one, you should do f of 2 first. You're welcome. And that should get you 8. F of 2 would be 2 cubed, so that's 8. And then you're going to substitute 8 into the g function. So then g of 8 would equal 8 squared plus 7, 64. So you should have gotten 71 as your final answer for that.
Where'd you get the f of 2 at?
Because of this, if I rewrite that, that would be g of f of 2. So the 2 goes into the function it's closest to first. So you put it into the f function. So I do f of 2, and then whatever I get, which would be 8, then I plug that into the next function, which is g. Okay, so if you take if you're putting an input in as a numerical value, you should get a numerical value as your output. But if you are only substituting a variable in, then you're going to have variables in your final answer. We're not going to just have one nice numerical value. So k of h of x, if I rewrite that, it looks like this. So when we're working inside out, they want us to take x and plug it into the h function. function. Well, if I plug x into my h function, won't I just get x plus 1? Right? H of x equals x plus 1. Thanks, Annabelle. We're now supposed to take this x plus 1 and put it into the k function. I'm replacing this h of x. So now it says k of x plus 1. So in the k function, wherever I see an x, I need to replace that with x plus 1. So instead of it starting off to say x squared, it's going to say x plus 1 quantity squared. Plus, and then it was 2 times x. So where that x is, I need to replace that with x plus 1. And then minus 4. So we're going to have to FOIL and distribute and get this into standard form. Yes, Miles? Repeat?
Just take the two given values and multiply them.
No, this means composition, not multiplying.
Yeah, but like the way that they're set up.
Does it work?
No.
I don't. Oh, you just wanted to take x plus 1 times that thingy?
Yeah,
you have to be careful. The open circle means you have to do the composition, so you gotta go inside. And then whatever you get for the inside function, we got x plus 1, I have to throw that into the next function on the outside. If it's just a dot, then you multiply them together. Okay, you try the next one. It's a composition function, which means, or with a variable, so you should have an x in your final answer. Like up here, and we plug 2 into the f function, I had a cube 2, so I got 8. Instead of plugging a number in, I'm plugging in the expression x plus 1. Does that make a little bit more sense? Yep, that's right. So this time we have to find k of g of x. So whatever's in these little parentheses, that's what you're substituting in. So going to the g function, I'm supposed to substitute an x in wherever I see an x. Well, if I substitute an x in wherever I see an x, I'll just get 3x plus 4. Okay. So this is replacing the g of x right there. So it becomes k of 3x plus 4. So now I need to take this 3x plus 4 and substitute it in for the x in the k function. So then I would have 3x plus 4 and then plus 2. So if I simplify this, your final answer should just be the square root of 3x plus 6. So your initial input, if it has an x, then your output should still have an x in it. If your initial input is a number, then your final answer should just be a number. Sound good so far? I have one more thing to tell you. If you notice on this one, it also tells you to find the domain. We're in the real number system. What kind of numbers can we not take the square root of in the real number system?
Negative.
Okay, so we have a restriction when it comes to square roots. I can't let the value underneath the radical be negative. So to find the restriction, you take the radicand, that's what's ever under the radical, and you set that equal to or greater than 0. Because I can take the square root of 0, it's 0, but I can't take the square root of a negative number in the real number system. So we want to make sure this value here is positive. So we're going to subtract 6 from both sides, and then I get 3x to be greater than or equal to negative 6. Divide by 3, and our x values, our inputs, have to be greater than or equal to negative 2. If it's less than negative 2, then I get a negative number underneath, and that's not going to work. So how we would write this back in first semester? Domain, negative 2 to infinity. Remember, the bracket means you can include that value, and then it goes on to infinity. So when you have a fraction, you have to check for domain restrictions. When you have a radical, the number has to be greater than 0, so you have to check for domain restrictions. Capiche? Okay, that's all I got for you.